game for the gold medal for the U.S. women and China. We do have time, however, I think, to show you a wrestling match. It's the first freestyle wrestling we've seen here in prime time. One of the Bannock twins, Ed Bannock of the United States, against Ismail Temiz of Turkey. Kurt Gowdy reporting from Anaheim.
Third round action in the freestyle wrestling here from the Anaheim Convention Center. This could be one of our very best matches so far. In fact, these two are co-favorites for the gold medal in this division. Ed Bannock, USA, University of Iowa, defeated Linz of Australia 15-2. Temiz of Turkey 11-0. Clark Davis of Canada defeated Cody of Senegal by a fall and drew a bye in the second round. Canada will be in the red, USA in the blue. Clark Davis was second in the world in 1982. There's Ed Bannock, three-time NCAA champ. The closest match the United States now has had in five matches, 11-0. And his brother will be wrestling, blue in the 220-pound division. They have a draw, and you know, here's two fellas meeting right away in the draw. Sometimes you get three or four of the best in the same pool.
Well, actually, in this weight class, we've had five of the best wrestlers in this weight division were right in the same pool. So the best matches in this weight class are going to be contested early. The gold medalists will, from in the other pool, going for the gold medal, may not be anywhere near as tough as either one of these guys.
All right, Davis is in the red. Bannock is in the blue. 2 3-minute periods, a minute intermission. Double elimination. Fair. Neither of these have been beaten yet.
There's Lou Bannock, or Ed Bannock, in on a single leg. He shifts off to a double. Attempt to counter,
got
but no good.
On
1 point.
Down. 1-0. Bannock leading to the USA in the blue. In control right now. Banner out of bounds.
Well, no, they're going to give two. He was in the process of turning with the gut wrench, and even though they went out of bounds, he scores the points. That's the rules in international wrestling.
3-0. Bannock leading. In the blue. Davis has been a strong world competitor the last 3 years.
He actually, in 1982, should have been the world champion. He made some mental mistakes in the match that cost him that world championship title. I'm sure he'd like to avenge himself here.
There are the coaches, the corners. 3-0. Bannock leading of the USA. 2 minutes to go in the first period. And the mat referee says, come on, let's go. Mix it up in here.
Well, he called for a caution there. He calls for a caution against Davis of Canada. That's his first.
Two more and he's disqualified.
Two more and he's disqualified. Three and you're out of the match.
Dan Gable, University of Iowa head coach, the coach of this United States wrestling team. Bannock in the blue. Two brothers. Here, Bannock.
Trying
Ed
to work
and Lou, and then we have the Schultz brothers, two sets of brothers.
He was trying to work here, a turn on top. He has an opportunity here to turn him over, score some points. If he can't do it, they're going to bring it. There it is. They call him back to their feet. They want more action. They bring him up to the center.
Minute 24 to go on the first period.
We should point out in each one of these matches, there are three referees, and two of the three must agree in order for any points to be awarded. Double leg. He drives it. Drives Davis to his back. He scores 3 points. Very powerful move for Ed Bannock.
6-0 now. Bannock of the USA.
6-0. Ed Bannock with
50. Turkey dominated wrestling in the Olympics in the 50s, and the Soviets came in. The Bulgarians, 70s, 60s. And this is a very powerful USA wrestling team. Even though the Soviets aren't here, Dan Gable, the USA coach, wishes they were. He thinks that they'd have done very well again. This is a boycott impacted event right now.
I think Dan Gable feels that it wouldn't have mattered who came here. Yeah. The USA team was ready to beat anybody.
6-0. We have 26 seconds to go in this first period. Bannock of the blue of the USA in the red. Clark Davis of Canada.
I really felt that this match would be a lot closer at this point. Davis is usually pretty good early in the match, but Bannock has really dominated him. Here he is again on a single leg, changes off to the double leg. He may lift him again. He's trying to get up to his feet.
Here's the left. Puts him down.
Well,
they
called the three, but I don't know. It didn't look like he really turned to his back, but he did get confirmation. They gave him 3 points.
So it's 9-0 at the end of the first period. Bannick of the USA over one of the better wrestlers in the world, Clark Davis of Canada.
And here we see the lift here now. If we watch this close, well, we really couldn't see it, although it doesn't look like he broke that 90-degree plane. Two of the three officials agreed.
All right, we'll be back with more wrestling after this. Now we're ready for the second period. Bannick of the USA out in front, 9-0. Davis is a 27-year-old veteran of international experience. And he's looking to become the first freestyle medalist for Canada since Joe Schleimer won a silver in 1928. They have to go back that far.
Well,
Ed Bannick and his brother Lou, born 5 minutes apart. A tragic family happening. Their home burned down, lost their parents, were adopted. Ed is one of 14 children. And wrestling has been a great binding for the two brothers. Parents left, separated after the fire. And then the adoption came.
All right, he's trying to work a gut wrench here now. He's put on top. The Canadian has his second caution. He's got to get going. He's trying to turn, get some back points. Referee says nothing happening, brings them back to their feet.
What has to be Davis' strategy now?
Well, he knows he's so far behind in this match that he's got to get some big throw. He's not used to being this far behind, at least in the last couple years in international, and I think he was a little bit surprised at how intimidating Ed Bannick was early. He's very powerful. He's very aggressive. He predicted when we talked to him early that he was going to really dominate his opponents, and he's really made a believer out of me.
Bannick in the blue, USA out in front, 9-0. Second period, just under 2 minutes to go.
Oh, a nice counter there by Davis. I was very surprised he worked out of that. There's a lot of power in those arms.
Bannick has won his first two matches, 15-2, 11-0.
Okay, that bout took place just a little bit earlier. Ed Bannick of the United States won it easily by a score of 11-2. However, the basketball game, the gold medal game for the United States women, is coming down to the final minute. We want to see the finish of that. Okay, Keith.
Jim, it is now 83-54, and everybody, all 12 players, have scored points in the ball game. And we now are less than a minute to play. The South Koreans, they're hanging in and fighting, but they're just simply overpowered by the taller American players, the deeper bench. The scoring off the bench tonight was something like 32-2 or something like that in favor of the Americans. Offensive rebounds, 21-7. Shot is up and a whistle and a foul. On the court right now for the United States, Carol Mencken-Schaup is in. She is the only married lady on the team. She's 6'3". She's 6'5". Her husband's 5'11". And you see now Pathead Summitt going down the bench and congratulating and thanking each one of these young women who participated in the 1984 Olympic women's basketball effort. And I should say this, she is the only woman coach these Olympic Games.
That's right. The Americans were a little slow getting started. I don't know what they expected from the Koreans, but it started out as a tough, aggressive, good game. Cheryl Merrill played a great game. And as you said, Pat Summitt, the only woman coach here in the games, and has to tell you a lot about the American game of basketball here for the women in the United States.
The ABA USA, which is the federation for basketball, operating all of its programs at an increased capacity. Ann Donovan scores, and that may be the last point to this ball game. 85-55, 30 points. Korea probably will have the last shot. Inside 10 seconds to go. Women's basketball became part of the Olympics in 1976. The Soviets won the gold. The Americans won the silver. You've got 2.3 seconds left to play in the ball game. This piece of gold, marked 1984, will belong to the American women.
A sweet victory. They played hard, and they deserved it.
The game is over. The United States women have won the gold medal in basketball, 85-55, over Korea. But say this about this Korean team. They have been thrashed roundly by Canada, Yugoslavia, and China in the qualifying tournament. The Soviet bloc boycott took Hungary and Cuba out of the tournament. The Koreans got a chance to come in, and they beat in the Olympic Games Canada, Yugoslavia, China, in that order. So tell me something about the pluck of that group, huh?
Well, they're tough. They're just as happy to have the silver.
They're hoisting their coach Choi into the air because he guided them firmly, sometimes gently, and sometimes harshly, just as all coaches have to do in moments like